So now we have something in Bootstrap that looks something like this. We wanted to end up with something looking like this, that's kind of the mock, right? But we ended up having something like this, where we have the welcome to Chatsies, this small Bootstrap setup, and then we have this image down here that kind of represents how the layout is right now. Now we're going to do the same in Material to kind of do the same setup and try and see if we get something that looks similar like we have in Bootstrap. So first of all, let's go and clean out our code and jump to the Material branch. So I'll do a git checkout right here to jump to that branch. Material was the name. There we go. Now, when we're on this branch right here, we need to do an npm install to kind of update all our packages. So I'll run that command. Now, we already talked about npm and version, so maybe after you go back to this version, you might have to go and check out if a new version of Angular Material is out there. It seems we're there now. Let's try and actually do a refresh of our program right here. I'll just rerun it. There we go. And notice everything went away. We don't have anything Bootstrap specific now. It's all gone. There we go. It's starting everything up. There we go. Now we are back to scratch. We are back to the first look and feel we had. And again, if we jump in here, everything looks like garbage again. So now we need to go and make the same layout that we have right here. But this time we're going to do it, as I said, in the Material setup. Now, notice right here, I want to start with this one and I want to center it like we had in Bootstrap. So we're going to have to look at how we can place the navigation probably up here, and then how we can kind of center this guy right here when we are logging in, so it'll be down here like we had in Bootstrap. In order to make the layout, I'm actually not going to use the basic 12 column layout that we used in Bootstrap. I'm going to use the flex layout that's more of a flow specific layout. So I want to start by showing you all the tools that we are going to use for the Angular Material setup. First of all, we have the Angular Material UI. Just like we had with Bootstrap, we have a wrapper right here that's Angular specific for the Material design components, and that's what we're going to use. So we already installed that one, we did that earlier, and that's going to stay as it is. The other thing we're using is going to be a flex layout. Now, you can use the basic flex layout, but somebody already provided an Angular flex layout that's kind of built for Angular. So that's the one we're going to use. Now let's go and install that this lesson, and we'll try and go in and figure out how we can actually use it. Jumping into the repository right here, scrolling down to the README file, and here's how you can use it. An npm install, flex layout, and adding this CDK right here. Let's jump into the code base and try and run that command. We'll fire the command. It installs new things for us that we need. And now we have that flex layout installed right here. Back in the documentation, in order to start using this, we need to add the flex layout module. So the flex layout module could actually be put directly into the app module, but that would mean we would have to also use it inside the chat module later on. So what we're going to do instead is we're going to create a new module that's for feature module setup like we have. We're going to add a shared module. So it's a new module that's going to contain everything that the other modules also uses, except for services. We'll get back to that later, but for now, just think of this new module we'll build. That'll be kind of the holding place for everything that's used throughout other modules. So let's go and create that module so you know what I mean. I've made a small CLI command here, ng generate module shared under the shared folder, and then it's flat. So it's going to generate the module directly under the shared folder. Now notice that shared folder is under app right here. There's a shared folder now, and here's the shared module. And this module is where we are going to have our beautiful, beautiful flex module layout right here. So let's just add that into that module right there. Import it. It also has the common module right here. So we'll import that one. There we go. And then I'll actually also export it because I want other modules to be able to use this module. So I'll do an export and I'll just add this right here, the flex layout module. There we go. Now this means that now this module is going to be used both by the app module if we want to do layout there and we want to do that. And also we're going to use this module in the chat module. So the shared module again is a place that we are going to put everything that's going to be shared across other modules. It makes perfect sense, right? So later on when we start using forms, we might have the reactive forms module right here as well. And then again, we need to put it once, and then every module that uses that reactive forms or that shared module will start getting the reactive forms module into their code base. Be aware that when you add a module here, it'll be shared across multiple modules, but this is the place we're going to start putting in the things that we want to share, like the flex layout. Sweet. If you don't put it in here, by the way, you might get issues. Actually, I've seen a few guys who have problems when they put it in here and they also put it in here, the flex module. if they put them directly in there, they actually get problems because of the way that Angular builds the code base. So I really feel it's a good idea to do the shared module. So that's it for this lesson. Now you know about the shared module that was added now to the chat module and the app module. And also we talked a little bit about how we install the flex layout module. So that's it for this lesson. See you next time. Bye.